Currently, you have a prepaid call from
California Island.
An inmate at the Unadjudicated Correctional Facility, San Diego, California. This call and your telephone number will be monitored and recorded. To accept this call, say or dial 5 now. Thank you for using Global Tail Link.
California Island Podcast, recorded over a state prison telephone and available to you for free at pensideout.org. I am positively positive that positivity will positively affect the positivity of our positive outlook on the future of the California Island Podcast. My name is Sean Khalifa.
And my name is Milton O'Reill, and I'm positively positive that the show will be positive.
We are your hosts, and today's show is about, have you guessed it yet, positivity.
And today we're speaking on positivity, those who are in prison, and those who are doing time in life.
Remaining positive is important for the best outcome in all things and battles. For example, whenever we go through struggles in life, we tend to want to think about all the negative aspects of what we're going through, but that's not going to give us a hand up in what we're trying to do, which is get through our struggle regardless of what it is and have the best outcome for us, for our families.
Now we're speaking on the positivity of being away from family, being positive for the young man that's coming into the institution, and being positive for the women that's out there that's holding it down for us. Now, if you stay positive, positive things will happen to you. I'm always stay positive in doing time, because in doing time, I learn a lot of stuff about myself and about others. It's not always negative. It's not always negative in prison. It's a lot of positive stuff that you can do in prison. For instance, like getting a GED, like getting a high school diploma, finishing high school diploma, graduating college, and learning a new trade.
I heard Milton talk about getting a new trade. I've tried my hand at getting a few trades. I wasn't successful. I never completed one of the courses. But what I have been able to do was write several books. And writing books has empowered me, strengthened me, gave me an identity. I can call myself an author. I no longer have to call myself just a prisoner. My legacy no longer has to be just my commitment offense, which landed me in prison. And now my future is bright. And at the end of the day, it kind of all led to this podcast. And I never thought I would be doing a podcast while serving a life prison sentence. Makes me think about what others would have done with this opportunity, such as Nelson Mandela, who had it harder than modern prisoners and was going through a hell of a time at Robben Island, staying strong, staying positive, and he ended up becoming the president of a nation, a reformed nation at that. And that's like hands down one of the most inspirational people we can look to as lifers in a prison system. And America's prison system is not designed for us really to succeed. It's kind of designed for us to be stagnated. There is a change in the country and even in California that is promoting rehabilitation, but a true rehabilitation, not just the word, but actually offering programs to us and giving us the opportunities to express ourselves creatively and live in a kind of create our own prison, the prison we want to see. So our behaviors are kind of influencing the programs we're getting at our current institution, and I can speak for myself in Milton that we were on high security level 4 yards, and now we find ourselves on a lower security level 2 yard with just a ridiculous amount of opportunities for growth and to live the life we want.
This call and your telephone number will be monitored and recorded.
As you can see, this call is legit. Our podcast is legit. We're on a real estate prison telephone. There will be interruptions every now and again from the automated recording, but that's just a part of the purity of our show. We want you to get it all, get the experience. And let me slide the phone to Milton. I'm sure he has something to tell you.
Yeah, this is my first time speaking to the public about being positive because I did a lot of negative stuff in prison, you know. It took me a long time. I bumped my head against the wall. Had a lot of incidents with the officers, a lot of incidents with inmates. But out of it came a better me. Now I appreciate my family more, my kids, my mother, my brothers and sisters, and my nieces and nephews. That's what I'm striving for, to get out of prison, to take care of my family, and to keep a positive mindset. That way I can carry it on to my family so they can keep a positive mindset not coming to prison. But there are a lot of brothers that's coming into prison with a lot of messed up mindset. They're upset about the time they have, and they're upset about the time doesn't fit the crime. So I got to stay positive for the brothers who are coming into prison so they can change their mindset and get out there and be a productive citizen of society. Now, we lacking in that area when it comes to getting out in prison. We always want fast money, so we have to slow down. We stay positive and know that things will come to us as long as we do positive things, you know. So I'm going to give it back to Khalifa before he can share some light on this.
This is Sean Khalifa. Martin had a dream. Martin had a dream. Sean Khalifa has a dream that this podcast will go viral, that we're going to reach millions of people, and that our positive outlook is going to have a positive effect on you and your family and your friends. And as you're driving to work this morning, as you arrived home today at the end of your long day at work, that in all things you do, you'll keep a smile. Even if your smile is crooked or you're missing a tooth, it's good to smile. I smile with some crooked teeth, but it's fine because it's what makes me who I am, makes me unique. And that's a blessing. That's a blessing that each of us are unique in the way that we are. Oh, man, I'm kind of happy to be talking to you right now. Life is good. Martin had a dream. It seems like the dream's coming true. Kendrick had a dream. He's one of the best rappers right now. Bob Marley, my main man. He helps me through the hardest times. I was just in that cell before I got out to do this podcast, and all I could think about when I was back there in that cell was getting out and speaking to the public and having my own radio show. And this is the reality of it. Serving life in prison, Milton serving life in prison. We're on the radio, on a podcast. It's the future, 2018. Stay positive.
Yeah, I believe everyone should wake up and smile and tell somebody that they love them, man. You know what I'm saying? Just give somebody a hug or something. You know what I'm saying? For me, I want to live vicariously through everybody who's doing positive stuff. You know, because I wake up every day with the same people, with the same upset mindset, man. All they need is a hug, but we scared to do so because of prison politics. You know? And, man, we just need a lot of light shed up there. And I hope y'all listen to this, man. You know, pay attention to what we're saying. It's our first time speaking on the radio. It's our first time doing this. So, you know, just give us some time, man. We'll get it together. We just want some positive stuff to happen for us out here. That's all we need. We need a lot of love in this prison system, man. We want to change prison from negative to positive, you know. It's been going on way too long, for too many years. We have to change the system. Like y'all changing what's going on the street, we trying to change what's going on up here. We trying to move the crowd up in prison. We going to do it, though. Just keep on pushing for it.
Martin had a dream. I'm happy to be back. Man, as a citizen of my prison institution, I try to make sure every day I'm making the right decisions. And when I'm faced with adversity, from whichever direction they come from, it could be from peers, it could be from custody, I try to respond the way I want to respond, not the way another person would like me to respond. I try to maintain the spirit that I've been given and the blessing I've been given by having a life sentence. because it's a gift from God, and it's true. We're so blessed. We just have to see the gift, utilize the gift, make the best of it, which we are doing. Ah, boy, oh boy, oh boy. I could cry right now, but I'm not, because I'm a strong man. I'm not weak. I got this. I'm just happy to be talking to you. I'm going to save my tears of joy till the phone hangs up, so you won't have to hear me on YouTube crying, man, because I'm a grown-ass man. Almost 30 now. Got locked up when I was 15. But I'm growing. It's been hard, but I'm getting there. And I'm positive that it's not over for me. It's not over for Milton. We got a bright future. You might see us on TMZ. Hopefully not, because TMZ is usually when you do something stupid. You might see us on Access Hollywood. You might see us on the local news when we get out of prison and we hugging our families and we crying and we kissing the ground, because that's probably what we're going to do. I just got out of ASEG and wanted to kiss the ground on a prison yard, so I can just imagine what it's going to feel like to get released for real and be back in society with my family and be able to have a positive impact on the community, because I wasn't doing that when I was out there. But then again, that's what the gift of life in prison has given me, a little bit of wisdom, a little bit of motivation. It inspired me, makes me aspire for greatness, for greater things. And when I do see an impact that I have on just that one person, it's powerful to see another person respond to your positivity with positivity when they're going through a horrible adversity that even I myself may have not been through, and I don't know that I can survive it or go through it, but I gave them the motivation to do so. That's powerful and that's deep, and that's what I hope California Island will give to you, the public. We'll give our prison spirit to the streets to motivate you in all that you do, whether you're an accountant, whether you're a professional athlete, whether you are a maid, whether you're an engineer or a rocket scientist. I mean, we're here to motivate you. We're here put the positivity out there on this Martin Luther King Day, the genesis of California Island Podcast. Ah, man. Milton, tell them something positive, man.
Well, I just gave two brothers a hug a couple of weeks ago, and they just got granted parole. Two brothers that's been down, one been down 31 years, another brother's been down 27. One of them was my Philly, and he's a beautiful brother, man, and he got denied a few times. And they finally gave him a date. Now he can go out there and spend some time with his mother, who has seen him 27 years, and his brother, too, and his nieces and nephews. So that's a beautiful thing, man. They letting people out of prison, and we are ready to get out. You know, we're ready to get out and stay out and be productive in society. And I hope that the brothers stay out of prison, man, and continue to give back what he took away. Because that's the thing, you know, I took a lot of stuff away from the streets. Took a lot of stuff away from people out there on the street. I made a lot of people sad. And I want to make a lot of people happy now. So I've been going through it in prison. I had a lot of time to think to myself what I've done wrong. And I learned that what I've done wrong, I can do right now. I got a lot of time to think about what I've been going through. And we both do. So we're just trying to shed some light on our situation. You know, letting everybody know that we're not just a number. You know what I'm saying? We're not just a dollar sign. You know what I'm saying? We're a human being. You know, that we can get out there and do what we're supposed to do for our family. And for people that are strangers, too. I want to look out for strangers, people who ain't got nothing going on the street. Give me a chance. I can give you a chance. You know, help me help myself. That's what I need. Help me help myself.
Martin had a dream. When I was in administrative segregation right now, I tried to make my presence felt amongst my peers, because some of them were in administrative segregation for some serious accusations. Some of them got accused of assaulting staff. Some of them had possession of weapons, and the men that were back there were facing years in the security housing unit, and they wanted to get an opportunity to reach a mainline prison, like one, for instance, one I am at right now. And when I was back there, I always spoke on positivity. Whenever something negative happened, whether we didn't get enough food on our tray, whether there was trash inside of our food on the tray.
You have 60 seconds remaining.
We're running out of time. Regardless of where you are, just be positive. Make sure you say something nice to your loved ones today. Give them a hug. Give them a kiss. Say something nice to your neighbor. ask him how he's doing today, check in with a stranger. If you're at the grocery store, be patient, be kind to everybody. Much love from prison out to the free world. We miss you guys. We'll be there one day.
This call and your telephone number will be monitored and recorded. You have 30 seconds remaining.
Hey, I want to say I love my baby mother, Lisa Richardson, and my son, Milton, and my other son, Aaron, and my daughter, Alicia Aurel. And I want to say hello to my mother and my sisters and brothers. I love y'all. I hope y'all listen to this, man. And I appreciate the listeners out there giving us some support. Take care of yourselves.